fiber morphology. So here we are taking morphological structure of wool fiber. Just already we have taken morphological structure of cotton fiber. So this word is not new for you. Morphological structure covers three types of structures: macro, micro, and microscopic view. So these three contents we are going to cover as a subtopic in morphological structure of wool fiber. So the macrostructure of wool, it's a crimped, fine to thick, regular fiber. The main property of this is having crimped configuration. This is the only fiber which is having natural crimp, and due to which it is possessing certain properties, specific properties. So in the macrostructure, as we have included in cotton, similarly length, the length of wool fibers ranges from about 5 cm for the finest wool to 35 cm for the longest and coarsest wool. So here, with the increasing of length, the fineness of fiber is not increasing. That is a specific point. That is a special point for wool fiber. Because in most of the fibers, as the length increases, fineness increases. But here in this case, the length is lesser, but the wool is finer. It is depending on the quality of sheep. So the length of the wool fiber ranges in this range, 5 cm to 35 cm. For textile purpose, wool fibers of 5 cm to 12 cm in length are preferred. This is the range of wool fibers which is used particularly for textile purpose. However, wool exists from 5 cm to 35 cm, but we are using only those wool fibers which are ranging between 5 cm to 12 cm. Diameter ranges from 14 micron for the very finest wool to more than 45 micron for the coarsest wool. And ki 14 micron se 45 micron ke beech mein diameter range vary karta hai. Jo fine wool hai, that is around 14 micron. Jaise jaise micron increase ho raha hai, waise waise coarseness of wool fiber is increasing. So that is about diameter range. The third point is length versus diameter ratio, or length versus breadth ratio. In general, fiber length to breadth ratio, or length to diameter ratio, ranges from 2500:1 for the finer, shorter wool to about 7500:1 for the coarser and longer wools. For finer and shorter wools, the L/D ratio is 2500:1, whereas for the coarsest and longer wools, it is 7500. Color, wool fiber may vary from off-white to light cream in color. This variation is due to the disulfide bonds, which seem to be able to act as chromophores. जो सल्फर कंटेंट है, जो हमने केमिकल कंपोजिशन लिया था उसमें 3-4% सल्फर दिखाया था, दैट इज फॉर्मिंग डाइसल्फाइड बॉन्ड्स, एंड ड्यू टू दिस सल्फर कंटेंट द कलर इज डिसाइडेड. सो द कलर इज रेंजिंग फ्रॉम ऑफ वाइट टू लाइट क्रीम. देन लस्चर, दे हैव लिटिल लस्चर. द कोर्सर लॉन्गर वूल फाइबर्स हैव लेस क्रीम एंड आर मोर लीनियर, enabling them to reflect incident light more evenly and result in a subdued luster. Jo fine wool hai uski luster kam hoti hai kyunki usme crimp zyada hota hai, aur crimp ka effect kya pad raha hai wo hum next slide mein cover karenge jab hum crimped configuration lenge. And jo coarser aur longer wool se uske, kyunki usme crimp kam hota hai to jo uski surface hai wo zyada even hoti hai, aur even surface hone se luster thoda sa badhega. To jo coarse aur long wool hai उसकी लस्टर ज्यादा होगी एज कंपेयर टू फाइन वूल. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ वूल इज क्रिम्प. फाइन वूल मे हैव एज मेनी एज 10 क्रिम्प्स पर सेंटीमीटर. जो फाइन वूल है उसमें क्रिम्प्स ज्यादा होते हैं, एंड दैट मे बी अप टू 10 क्रिम्प्स पर सेंटीमीटर. एक सेंटीमीटर में 10 क्रिम्प्स हो सकते हैं. व्हाइल कोर्स वूल हैव लेस देन 4 क्रिम्प्स पर 10 सेंटीमीटर. क्योंकि बहुत ज्यादा कोर्सनेस की तरफ जाएंगे तो मैक्सिमम कोर्सनेस की तरफ जाएंगे तो उन फाइबर्स में क्रिम्प इतना कम है, दैट कैन बी सीन हियर इन विद इन द फाइबर ऑफ 10 सेंटीमीटर ओनली 4 क्रिम्प्स आर देयर. जबकि फाइन वूल के केस में 10 क्रिम्प्स पर सेंटीमीटर है, यहाँ पर 10 सेंटीमीटर ओनली 4 क्रिम्प्स आर देयर. सो दैट इज द very high variation as far as cream per unit space is concerned from fine wool to coarse wool. And that's why the difference in quality is also there. As the diameter of wool fiber increases, the number of crimps per unit length decreases. This is that coarseness badh rahi hai, crimp kam ho raha hai. Due to crimped configuration, wool fabric have more warmth, very good elasticity. And one more thing is there, which is not the plus point, which is the minus point of wool, that it is giving prickling sensation, chubne wala sensation deta hai, that is uncomfortable to the person who is wearing those fabrics, and particularly in a hot atmosphere. So we will try to understand this last paragraph in the next slide, how the warmth is increased, how it is producing good, how it is giving good elasticity and giving prickling sensation due to this crimped configuration. The crimped configuration prevents wool fibers from aligning themselves too close when being spun into yarn. जब बहुत सारे fibers के bunch को लेके जब twist करके उसको spin करते हैं yarn के अंदर, तो जो crimped configuration है, crimp means waviness, that zigzag structure, the wavy structure is known as crimp. And if the fiber is having waviness or zigzag structure, then it will not get aligned, and the fibers will not come closer, because this crimped if the fiber is straight, then they can be placed very close to each other. But when they are having irregular structure, this crimped like waviness structure, then it cannot be put very close to each other. As a result, it is possible to have wool textile material with air spaces occupying about 2/3 of the volume. Ye jo dono fiber ke andar, kyunki crimped configuration hai, wavy structure hai, to unke beech mein gap zyada hoga, space zyada hoga, and due to this space lagbhag air ka jo part hai, that is 2/3 of the volume. Jo ye jo space hai, khali space hai, it will be 2/3 of the volume. Agar aap yarn ka total volume dekhen, to usme jo fiber hai aur स्पेस है, जो फाइबर कंटेंट जहां पर है और स्पेस जहां पर है, तो स्पेस इज 2/3, इट मींस फाइबर इज ओनली 1/3 ऑफ द टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ द यार्न. सो मोर एयर स्पेसेस मींस मोर एयर पॉकेट्स आर देयर. इन दिस वे एयर पॉकेट्स आर जनरेटेड विद इन द वूल यार्न. वूल के यार्न के अंदर एयर पॉकेट्स जनरेट हो जाती है, एंड द वार्मथ ऑफ वूल फैब्रिक इज ड्यू टू मोर एयर स्पेसेस. ये एयर स्पेसेस ज्यादा होने से, because air is a bad conductor, it works as a good insulator, and that's why the heat cannot be transferred from one side to other side, and they give us warmth feeling. So the reason behind the warmth feeling is this crimped configuration. Due to this crimped configuration, the air spaces, the air pockets are formed in the yarn between fiber to fiber, and that is around 2/3 of the total volume, and that's why it gives warmth quality to the wool textile materials or wool fabrics. Is it clear? First point, why the wool textile materials are warmth? The answer will be this. Second, why the wool is having good elasticity? The very good elasticity of wool fibers is mainly due to the crimp. It makes the fiber elastic and enables the wool fiber to return to its crimped configuration. जब हम इस पर फोर्स अप्लाई करेंगे तो क्रिम्प ओपन होगा, वेविनेस है तो वो स्ट्रेट हो जाएगा, तो और जैसे हम वापस फोर्स रिमूव करेंगे तो ये वापस अपना जो क्रिम्प्ड कॉन्फ़िगरेशन है, इसका ओरिजिनल शेप है, वो रिगेन करेगा, और उसको रिगेन करके वापस अपनी ओरिजिनल पोजिशन में रिटर्न हो जाएगा. दैट्स वाई वूल इज नोन एज अ वेरी गुड इलास्टिक फाइबर, एंड द रीजन इज ऑल द रीजन फॉर दिस गुड इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी इज ऑल्सो द क्रिम्प्ड कॉन्फ़िगरेशन. सो फर्स्ट इज due to this crimped configuration, wool textile materials are warmth, more warm as compared to other textile materials. It is more elastic as compared to other textile materials. And the third one is the unruliness of the crimp. Jo crimp ka jo irregular structure hai, this irregular structure is known as unruliness. Kyunki unruliness ka matlab hai ki ye straight nahi hai aur एक लाइन में नहीं है. रूलिंग मींस लाइन, सो अनरूलिंग मींस इट इज नॉट इन अ लाइन, इट इज हैविंग अ क्रिम्प्ड कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, अ वेवी स्ट्रक्चर. wool fiber ends end to project above the wool textile material surface. And because ये straight नहीं है, crimped configuration है, तो bent part होगा इसका. जो bent part है वो wool textile materials की surface से project out होंगे. तो fiber के जो ends हैं, they are projecting out of the surface of the textile material. जिस textile material को हमने उस wool fiber से बनाया है, वहाँ पर ये wool fiber के जो ends हैं, वो project out होंगे. These projecting ends. These projecting fiber ends cause a prickling sensation. चुभने वाला sensation देंगे जब भी वो touch करेंगे हमारी body को, हमारी skin को. Because it stimulates the blood circulation of skin. क्योंकि एक point है, जो fiber का जो point है, वो जब skin के particular part पर touch करेगा तो वहाँ पर stimulate करेगा blood circulation को, और blood circulation stimulate होने से prickling sensation होगा. And that is not a comfortable sensation. That is uncomfortable. In warm and temperate climates, the wearer may find this sensation uncomfortable. सर्दियों में तो फिर भी, क्योंकि सर्दियों में blood circulation बढ़ने से इतना issue नहीं होगा. अगर गर्मी है तो already blood circulation तेज होता है, और गर्मी इसकी वजह से prickling sensation, blood circulation बढ़ेगा, stimulate होगा. Due to this, we will feel uncomfortable at that particular part, particular skin part of the body. These are the three major properties or major characteristics associated with wool textile fabrics or wool fabrics or wool textile materials. One is, it gives warmth feeling. They are very good elastic, and this prickling sensation. If there is any question, you may write in the chat. You may write in the chat box, or you may ask me on WhatsApp related with this. Then I will explain the next class. And PPTs I will share just after this class up to the topic which I have already covered. Yes, this last topic we'll take today. We have still 7 minutes. Microscopic appearance of wool fiber. Same is cotton. Here we are going to study the longitudinal view as well as cross-sectional view of wool fiber. The longitudinal microscopic appearance of wool is the overlapping surface cell structure. That is a particular word you have to remember, overlapping surface cell. If you have seen the skin of fish ki skin aapne agar dekhi hai to jis tarah se wahan pe scaly structure hota hai, scales dikhai deti hai, similar type of scales are shown in the longitudinal view of wool fiber. This overlapping surface cells are known as scales. Inko hum scale bolte hain. And the wool is having scaly structure. Same is the skin of the fish. This overlapping surface cell can be seen when we are observing this wool fiber, longitudinal view of the wool fiber under the microscope. And these structure cells point towards the tip of the fiber. The scales give the wool fiber a serrated surface. Serrated means जो जैसे गियर्स होते हैं, गियर्स के अंदर टीथ निकले हुए होते हैं, उस तरह का सरफेस हमें मिल रहा है, सेरेटेड सरफेस ड्यू टू स्केल्स. द फाइन लाइंस सीन अक्रॉस द फाइबर आर द आउटलाइंस ऑफ द एपिथेलियल सेल्स. और वूल फाइबर के जो बाउंड्री के ऊपर जो लाइंस दिख रही हैं, दैट इज ड्यू टू एपिथेलियल सेल्स. मीन्स सरफेस कवरिंग वाली जो सेल्स हैं, द क्यूटिकल पार्ट जो है, उसकी वजह से दिखाई देगी. द प्रेजेंस ऑफ अ डार्क सेंट्रल लाइन or canal, just like lumen in the cotton fiber, similarly here this dark central line or canal along the length of the wool fiber indicates the presence of a medulla. In cotton we call it lumen, in wool we call it medulla, the hollow canal. The dark central line or canal which runs along the length of the wool fiber, that is known as medulla. And the cross section is usually oval in shape with medulla in center. Here this is cross section. So in the cross section you can see the dark boundary is shown, that is this scaly structure, this overlapping surface cell structures. You can assume it as a cuticle, just like cuticle in the cotton. This is epidermic cells. The center and the main bulk of the wool fiber, the center part, the main part of the wool fiber is known as cortex. And this center dark part, which is running as a hollow canal, that is known as medulla. And this is longitudinal view, in which you can easily see this scaly structure. These scales or this overlapping surface cell, these overlapping each other, these surface cells. And this is known as scales. And this scaly structure is giving a particular type of properties or quality to the wool fiber. So this is longitudinal and cross-sectional view. Now it is shown in a simple manner in this diagram. This is longitudinal view. These are surface cells which are overlapping with each other. And this is oval shape cross section. And in the center, we have taken a hollow canal, a dark line that is indicating medulla. This is about the coarse wool, longitudinal and cross sectional view of coarse wool, because coarse wool is having a difference in fine wool that can be seen in the next diagram. Can you observe the difference here? The longitudinal view is almost same, but here you can see the medulla is absent. This is only the oval shape and medulla is absent. If you compare with the previous diagram, here the medulla is there in the coarse wool. Here you can see medulla is absent. So medulla is found only in coarse wool fibers, not in fine wool fibers. Next topic is microstructure of wool fiber. And same is cotton fiber. Cotton fiber is consisting of four components. Wool fiber is consisting of three main components. Outside boundary is cuticle. The inner part, the main part, the bulk of the fiber is cortex. And the hollow central canal is known as medulla. So medulla can be compared with lumen. Cortex can be compared with primary wall and secondary wall of cotton. And cuticle can be compared with the cuticle of cotton. The outermost boundary is known as cuticle. The central main bulk of fiber, cortex, and the hollow canal, which is found only in the coarse wool fiber, that is known as medulla. Here you can see the diagram. However, I will repeat it again in the next class, but you can just have a look of the morphological structure, the microstructure of cotton wool fiber. So the microstructure, यहाँ कट करके इसलिए दिखाया हुआ कि इंटरनल पार्ट भी इसमें दिखाई दे सके. कॉर्टेक्स का जो इंटरनल पार्ट है वो यहाँ पे शो हुआ है, इसलिए इसको यहाँ पे कट करके दिखाया हुआ है. एंड कॉटन में हमने लॉन्गिट्यूडनली लिया था, इसको हमने वर्टिकली लिया हुआ है. सो हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज क्यूटिकल. क्यूटिकल इज हियर द क्यूटिकल इज डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री पार्ट, एंडोक्यूटिकल, एक्सोक्यूटिकल एंड ईपीक्यूटिकल. ये मैं वापस लूंगा, इसको रिपीट करूंगा. ईपीक्यूटिकल इज द आउटर मोस्ट, एक्सोक्यूटिकल central part of cuticle, and endo means the end of the cuticle, inside. This is outside, center and inside. So cuticle is divided into three. This is showing, this particular part is showing cortex divided into two different parts, orthocortex and paracortex. And these are the cortical cells. Number of cortical cells are there, which are shown here. This is epithelial cell or wool fiber surface, that is cuticle part. And this is inner structure of this cortical cells, that is divided into wool polymer, then protofibril, then microfibril, and then macrofibril. We have less than 1 minute, so we will end the class here. And if you have any queries, you can ask me on WhatsApp or in the chat box. Chat box mein pee karna tha aapko, agar nahi kiya to abhi kar de, because we have only seconds. एंड जिन्होंने स्क्रीनशॉट लेना था अगर नहीं लिया हो तो अभी ले लें. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू सर.